Hello friends, welcome back. This is the second video on find and search. And this video, before going to this video, please refer to my previous video in the link section. In the last video, I showed you how to use to find certain text, the find formula and the search formula. And you know, the same formula, this is a lengthy formula and this is a same formulas which can be used for the same things in two different ways. So it is up to you how you, if you would like to go for find or search option. Now in this formula, I have seen there is one more issue, though it is not case sensitive. Now if I have to search multiple words and multiple lines, how can that be done? Now you can see this is also an invoice, but it has been written in a shorter format. And in the same way, this is also the same thing. Now in case if you want to get this cell also as a payable, what can be done? So the easy way is that you should make an OR formula in this, like same it has been done over here. So the same OR formula should be added in the is number search. So how to do that is, like, you have to copy this section. Copy this and you have to make an OR formula after if. And after that you have to paste this. Now this is a logical one. So we have to segregate with the comma in this. So this is going to be logical too. So now this OR formula also, you can mention this as INV. Now this is and this has to be segregated. So we will be adding one more parenthesis here. This will be the value if it is true, and this will be the value if it is false. So now let's see, this has to be payable, this true. So you can see that if it is possible. Yes, you can see now it has been changed to payable because of we have added one more condition. Now you can see this also has become a payable. So this is the way we can add multiple criterias to search. And now in case if I change this into INV, now you can see this has gone. This is not searching it. Only if I make it into INV, it has become payable. Now in case if you want to make this also payable, if you have something like IN, it doesn't really change here. So if you want to have this word add also a payable, then again you have to add one more criteria to that, and that you have to make as IN in small letters, in small or even big, it doesn't really make any issue. So if you see that if you can make this even this as IN, I'll remove this so that we can have a good view. So you can see now these are non-payables. These are non-payable. Now if you want to make that also in a payable format form, then again you have to do is you have to copy this. Control C. And again you have to add a condition. Either you can add in the end or you can add in the middle. So it will search that condition in the beginning. So if you want, I can add you from the beginning also. So if you add anywhere, it doesn't really matter right now, unless it searched the first item. So if I make this into IN, this is logical one, and I want to segregate this. So I want to make this logical two. This is logical two, and this is logical three. And if you go and check the if condition, it is value if true is payable and the value if false is none. So now when I pull it down, so these are the areas which have to be checked. So now you can see it's checking for both the cases, small case, upper case, or non-sensitive case also. It is checking the things. And now you can see the formula has increased a bit. But if you had to done the same in find, you should have written multiple criteria for all the case sensitives. So it would be nearly two times bigger formula in find, and it is half the way in search formula. So it's case sensitive. We don't want to mention again and again. So once we have added this, automatically it will decide the check in the text. So if you want to search any name or number or anything, you can use this formulas. And now I'm going to show this in the next video. I'm going to show you how the same thing can be done in a Power Query with applying both the formulas and in a different way. So how this Power Query formula is different from the normal Excel formula. So I hope you got this video useful, and I would like you to subscribe my channel and share this video and give your comments. And let's see you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching this.